Hey everyone, Alan here. Wanted to share a little lesson out of Kelly McCann's Combatives book. Under chapter 3, Combatives Principles, Kelly talks about principle number 1, go armed. And Kelly says this should be an obvious concept. No matter how skilled you are, the use of any type of weapon provides you a significant advantage. Got to agree with him, right? Now, he goes in here with a couple sidebars. Quality purpose-built weapons. Good choices include a collapsible 21-inch baton, a small fixed-bladed knife, a pocket stip, coup baton, yawaro, or kopo, a folding knife that can also be used as a point impact tool, pepper spray, or a handgun. You know, and I'd add reflex protect in there with the pepper spray. You know, as you know, I personally work with reflex protect, and I prefer reflex protect over pepper spray in a lot of different situations. Okay. Now, he also says being armed is a mindset, which I agree with 100%. Improvised weapons are not objects. They're a mindset that you have. Now, what he says, you're never completely unarmed. You just have to see the weapon attributes in ordinary items. For example, a high-powered flashlight can be used as an impact weapon and will take away an attacker's night vision. A bottle is a bludgeon. Or when broken, an edged weapon. An empty can torn in half creates a gouging tool. Virtually anything with some strength can be used as a pocket stick. Exactly. Improvised weapons, that's a mindset, not an object. Because you can use anything as a weapon. Use a credit card as a weapon. Remember Steven Seagal in that one movie? You know, I learned years ago in high school how to use a newspaper or a magazine rolled up. Use that as a weapon. Sean Penn showed me how to put a couple cans of soda into a pillowcase. That movie when he, you know, back in the 80s where he beat the heck out of people with it. You know, it's as much as you can imagine. Those are the weapons that are out there. So you can always be armed. Now, Kelly goes on to talk about the most important thing about any weapon is that it acts as a trigger when coupled with good situational awareness and attack recognition skills. When you find yourself reaching for your weapon, it triggers heightened situational awareness, compelling your immediate escape from the situation. In my opinion, if you don't arm yourself with a legally concealed weapon or an improvised weapon when necessary, you're negligent. When is it necessary? If you knew, you could schedule when to carry a weapon and when not to. You should always carry a weapon or an item that can be used as a weapon, period. Arm yourself with a weapon that can be legally carried in the jurisdiction where you live. Okay, so that's Kelly's thoughts on arm yourself, and that's his first principle of combatants. Now, the one thing he mentioned there, which I teach a lot too, I think it's so important. When you take out your can of pepper spray, your can of reflex protect, other self-defense tools, or you put your hand making sure, you know, I don't want you always feeling and checking your weapon if you're concealed carrying, but when you're ready for something because you think something's not quite right, you know, you're walking out of the mall, it's late at night, you feel something's not right, you want to be a little safer as you walk across the parking lot, so you pull out your defensive weapon, that right then and there, by taking this and putting it in your hand, increases your situational awareness, like Kelly was talking about. And right there, that will make you less likely to be a victim in the first place than if you're walking out to your car, looking at your phone, oblivious to what's going on, making yourself an easy target. You take this out, it's in your hand, you're being aware, you're less likely to even need this. You get to your car, lock the door, get the heck out of there. Okay, so that was just a short little lesson. Go armed, based off of Kelly McCann's Combatives book, a book I highly recommend. Check it out. There's some companion DVDs that go with this. You know, I have those over on the shelf too. All really good stuff. So that's a little lesson for today. Take care. Stay safe.